Welcome back to Super Mario 64. We're going to continue with Womp's Fortress. This is part 3 of the playthrough. Alright, shoot into the wild blue. Okay, oh, there's the owl. Can't remember his name, but, you can actually, that's how you get to that cage star that I showed in the last video. I believe this star here is the one where you knock out the corner. And in order to do that, you have to talk to this bomb so he opens up the cannon. In some of the worlds, he is near the cannon. If you remember the first in Bomb's battlefield, there was a Bomb buddy standing near the cannon. Here he's next to it again, but in other worlds, he's not anywhere near the cannon. Okay, and that was the right one. You actually take damage by opening the star there. The corner where the star is there. But, you definitely want to head in, I guess, with a full life bar. Ooh. Go back to sleep. There we go. There we go. But if you need a little extra life on your life bar, they had that coin ring in the water down there. Okay, I'm just gonna slide down and grab this one. There we go. Okay, so that one's pretty easy. The only thing is, like, knowing where that is. Oh, that's actually not the right one. Oops. Okay, well, that's Blast Away the Wall. I think that's actually starred. That's a later one. Oh, that's number 6. Okay. Shoot into the wild blue. Okay, now I'm confused as to which one this is. I'm gonna start grabbing. I'm gonna start, like, grabbing stars in here, and they're just gonna be, like, completely the wrong ones. Cause, yeah, you know what? I'm just gonna start doing that. I'll narrow it down to the ones I know. Okay, so let's talk to the owl here again. I'm just gonna grab the caged one. And now this one is somewhat difficult to get. Let's see if I can get it. Because you have to aim to the cage, and it's kind of awkward because he drops you from, like, a really high elevation. So, if you miss, you have to wait for him to come back. I can hear him. I don't see him, though. I just remembered where the star is. Okay. This is the one that involves a cannon as well. That's why I got confused, because it involves the cannon, but this one is the one where you shoot over here. Right over here. For this one, if you miss the target, you can potentially fall off, but usually I like to aim for this pillar here. I'm gonna aim kind of precisely so I don't aim too high. Okay, actually I didn't aim high enough. Okay, let's try that again. There we go. If you notice there was a star up there, that should be the one for this mission. Like I said in the very first video of the playthrough, there's gonna be stars where I don't grab in order. I mean, I already ignored one in the first world, so... Yep. Oh, grab it. Okay, you have to jump for it. Even though, like, the star was, like, on his head. Okay, that should have been the right... Yeah, there you go. Shoot into the wild blue. Okay, that is star number 10. Alright, so next up is red coins on the floating aisle. Okay. So, throughout a few of the missions in the game, I've actually grabbed a bunch of the red coins already, so most of their locations are known. I kind of skipped a few of them, though. I don't think there's any here, no, there's none. Alrighty. You know, I kind of regret not saying anything about it, but this game had a version on the DS called Super Mario 64 DS. Super Mario 64 DS. It's actually almost a different game. Like, the gameplay is very... It added a bunch of new features. Like, first of all, the biggest one was the fact that you could play as four different characters. Like, you started out the game not as Mario, but as Yoshi. And then you can unlock Mario, Luigi, and Wario. And they all had different traits and stuff like that. And the game added in, I think, 30 new stars, so there was 150 total. I actually never completed that one because back when the original DS came out, you know, like the 3DS now, that's the current Nintendo handheld, it has like a circle pad that, you know, kind of mimics the analog stick really well. But the, if you remember the original DS, and also the DSi and the DS Lite and stuff like that, they didn't have that, so you had to use the control pad. Just imagine playing this game with a D-pad, and it just didn't work very well. So the control scheme for certain parts of the game worked okay, but in others, oh, that coin's gone. In others, it was, like, very frustrating. But what's interesting is if you play Super Mario 64 DS on a 3DS, it actually controls really well since you have the circle pad, and you can actually play the game with the circle pad. But yeah, that's almost a completely different game for the most part. I mean, a lot of the missions in this game are in that one, but some of them are actually easier, some are more difficult. But it's not a bad game. Like I said, the control scheme on the original DS, or you know, anything not 3DS, didn't work that well, but the game itself wasn't bad. Well, to me anyway. I'm sure a lot of people... Well, some people liked it, some people didn't. But that's... if I haven't been asked about it yet, I probably will be, but I don't have any plans on playing through that now. Especially since I'm playing through this one, the original one. If I was to play through that one, it probably wouldn't be for a while. I mean, I can record that now because I have the 3DS capture device. I could play that on my 3DS and record that now. That's gone. I'm gonna grab more coins here. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to grab the 8 red coins but also get them 100 coins. Oh, wait, I already knocked him out, that's right. So that was pointless. Oops. Okay, for this one, you have to stand on the end and grab the coins as it swings around. Okay, that extra life. I usually don't grab that one because it just falls down. It makes you have to drop down from here. Oh, I forgot there's coins in that spot, too. Whoa. Mario got squished a little bit there. I don't remember how many coins you can cause the pop out just from jumping over him. But I'll take what I can get. It'd be awesome if I can get like the rest of them from him. I think that's it though. Yeah, so that was 5. And then you get 5 more from defeating him. Okay. Actually, once I defeat this one here, or get the 5 from jumping over him, and then ground pound him, that'll be it. I'll have 100. Well, actually, I'm going to have more, because like it counts like any coins you get after you get the star. Like, basically, once you finish the mission, it counts how many coins you have at the end, if I remember right. So if I have over 100, it'll show in the total, like at the end here, like the high score, it'll show like, you know, 105 or whatever. There we go. And it's really important, I mentioned it in I think the previous part, but it's very important that when you get the 100th coin in any world, you want to make it so that the 100th one is Like one that you can easily grab. Because you don't want to be stuck with that coin in like a really dangerous spot. Or one that takes a lot of effort to get to. Okay, this part, I don't like this part either. Just because of the camera angle and you can't really rotate it to a good spot. How many coins do I have? Okay, so these are the last two. And there it is. Okay, so this one is down near the beginning. I might as well just grab these. Like I pointed out, where the that one star I got in the last star I got, where you launch yourself from the cannon, that has more coins on it. If you really want to get most of or all the coins in this world, you can grab those, but I'm not going to bother. I already have, like, 120. I might as well just grab these while I'm here. Okay. There we go. I wonder if this is one of the ones where you can punch the butterflies. There's like, a thing you can do by punching the butterflies, but maybe it's not here. Oh, I missed a coin up there. Oh, well. I have 131, that's overkill. Well, actually, there is a small benefit. Like, if you get 150, you get an extra life. Okay, but let's head back and get... Which one is this? Star 5. This is actually the last one of Womp's Fortress. And this is the one that I almost did... a little bit ago. Okay, let me see if I can get this one. I don't think I've ever gotten this on my first try. But, like, once I grab the mission, I don't think I've ever gotten it immediately. Oh, I'm in a... This is, like, a really bad camera angle. And he slowly drops, too. So, like, I guess you can wait till he does that. Oof! Okay, I actually almost had that there. Alright. I mean, like I said, you can wait till... Like, he drops down a little bit lower, so it's easier to drop yourself into the cage, or you can... just wait till he's, like, near it and just guess where he's gonna drop you. That's actually what I usually do, but I also usually fail... to get into the cage that way, too. Oh, nope, that was a little too far. Ah, now I gotta wait for him again. Okay, but once I'm done here, I already have 12 stars, so this will be star 13. I can actually... before I head into World 3, probably in the next part, I'll start grabbing... some of the castle stars, like the secret slide, both secret slide stars. I could probably get the wing cap by now, and then get star 5 of... Oh, nice. He was actually still yelling as I grabbed the star. But star 5 of Bomb Battlefield, because I kind of skipped that. Alrighty, so like I said, that was star number 13. Go up here. And as the game pointed out, I can actually fight Bowser now. I could have fought him several stars ago. Oh yeah, so right here, when the light is shining in the middle, and you look up at the sky while you're, not the sky, the ceiling, as you're standing in that, that brings you to the wing cap level, where you can get the wing cap and also a castle star. But I'm gonna start that in the next video. I'll do the secret slide stars, and then that one, and then grab star 5 of Bomb Battlefield. Alrighty, that's the end of this part. Thanks for watching.